You're starring in one of the summer's big movies. What's it feel like to be part of that franchise?
Nervous.
Nervous, really?
Yeah, no. It feels very honored, you know. It's a great experience, you know. This is what I dreamed of as a kid, you know, to make a big swashbuckling action film with, you know, Rob Cohen as the director and Brendan and Jet Li as the mummy and Maria Bello, who's got a lot of spunk. So, you know, it's quite humbling. I mean, every kid around the world would want to play my role. So, I'm grateful I got it. It's like winning the lotto. I won the lotto. Just financially, yeah.
Now tell me about getting ready for it physically, because I imagine it's very strenuous for you to play this part, right?
Yeah. No, it was a big shoes to fill. You know, Brendan's such a great entertainer and a great actor, and he had such a big impact and made these films, which were a huge hit. And then he's sharing it with me a little bit now, and with the rest of the cast. And you know, and I really enjoyed working with him and taking that on board. So, you know, I hope it does well, and I hope I live up to the expectations of the fans and everything like that. So we'll see how we go.
Is there a lot of wire work and green screen and all that? What's it like for you to deal with that?
Oh, it's there was a lot of wire work because I mean Jet Li's the mummy, so that kind of means there's going to be a lot of martial arts involved and flying and kicking. Yeah. And I was wired up, and that was great fun. You know, the harness and you know spinning around, and you know they really were thorough on it. You know, and made sure it was full of wire work, and Michelle Yeoh is in it, and she's just great with the wire work, and so it's good.
So you actually have to face off against Jet Li. You actually have a fight scene with him.
It's a tag team between me and Brendan, just quietly. Yeah, well, we couldn't beat him on our own, you know. It's Jet Li, you know, and you know that would be a bit unrealistic to fans. So I guess yeah, we're doing a little bit of a tag team, you know. Brendan kind of gets more of it because you know he's more of the adult and he's fought a lot more than I have, so you know. But I mean, I do get a fair share of crack with him at the whip with him, so. Hopefully it's good. I haven't actually seen it yet.
You haven't?
No. I like it when it's fully done. So it's still in its final touches. Still a couple of special effects to be added in. Rob's very thorough like that. He likes to watch the actors watch it when it's completely done. It's quite, you know, fair enough. And so I hope to look forward to it. Be good.
Do you have any accidents on the set?
Actually, yes, I did.
Yeah,
I injured my knee. And it was actually funny because, you know, they threw me up buildings. They made me jump and explosions and all that, but then just in a simple scene jumping off a flight of stairs, I tore ligaments in my knee, and that was it, you know. And but you know, they were really good. I was on physio every day, and you know, twice a day, and it got better in about 2 weeks and I was back on.
So is this one actually like passing the franchise on to you? Will we see a spin-off with you as the lead character?
I don't think that's where they want to go. I mean, if they do, they do. But I mean,
would you be okay with that?
Yeah, I would be. I mean, it would be pretty hard because I respect Brendan a lot, and I think Brendan's such a big entity with the mummy. He is the mummy, you know. So I mean, I'd rather like continue working with him. He's such a great actor, and you know, and Maria and the whole family relationship's so good in film, and there's a great banter between us. So I really hope that we can all carry it on together. But if they happen to ask me to do it, then, well, I'll probably have to do it, you know, and I'd love to do it, so.
Did they sign you on for more than one film?
Yeah, they did. They signed me on for three, but they didn't say primarily that it's for me to take over the series. I don't think that's where they want to go with it. I think they want to
keep the family together.
Yeah, well, that's where the chemistry is in the film.
So how does this one differ from the past Mummy movies?
Oh, this one differs very much so. Well, it's not Egypt anymore. It's China. And yeah, it is strange, and I think, you know, it's a lot more, there's a certain maturity about this film, you know, it goes a little bit more darker and mysterious and a little bit more, you know, rougher on the edges in some ways, you know, and so, and it's changed directors, Rob Cohen. I mean, not that Stephen Sommers, he loves the project, but he passed it on to Rob because, you know, he's got other projects to work on, and I think Rob did a terrific job, and I think he wanted to put his own stamp on it, and I think that's very much in the film, his stamp, so it should be good.
Anything else in the works?
Well, actually, just working a little bit in Australia. I did a film with Toni Collette called Black Balloon, playing an autistic kid. So it's actually, yeah, one extreme or the other. So we're looking for that film to come out to America very soon in the next couple of months. There's no specific date yet, but they're looking to release at some point. So hopefully it does really well.
Autistic. I mean, that's very hard to portray on film. How did you study that?
6 months worth of studying and basing it on primarily one guy that that they wanted me to base it on, which was part of the family. So, you know, I studied him, filmed him, you know, watched him, you know, researched it, and you know, and I think I did good things. We took out the Crystal Bear Award at the Berlin Film Festival. So hopefully, you know, it does really well.